Remember that when the Lord Jesus Christ gathered his apostles on the night of the Passover, again, no Easter, it is Passover, on the night of when the Passover lamb was going to be sacrificed, he gathered his apostles. Actually, he encouraged them to go to a certain location to find a certain man, a certain house, and go there and get them to prepare prepare the place so that they can celebrate the Passover. So the Passover was celebrated so that it would begin what he was going to do, which is to shed his life and kill him, be sacrificed for us. Christ, our Passover lamb, was sacrificed for us. So we are going to read 1 Corinthians, and if you may, Bratunde will read it for us, and we will all stand to hear 1 Corinthians 11. And if Bratunde will come to the front, please, so that we can all hear. 1 Corinthians 11, 23 to 31, please.
1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 23. For I have received of the Lord that which also I have delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. Chapter 24. And when he has given thanks, he broke it and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After the same manner, also, he took the cup when he has supped, saying, "This is the cup of the New Testament in my blood. Do ye as oft as ye drink it in remembrance of me." 26. For as often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do show the Lord's death till he come. Wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and the blood of the Lord. Let a man examine himself, so that he eat, let him eat of this bread and of that cup. For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not designing the Lord's body. For this cause many are weak, sickly among you, and many sleep. For if we would join ourselves, we should not be judged.
Amen. So this is the word of God helping us to know what responsibility we have towards his holy communion, which is to say that when we partake of the Holy Communion, we have to prepare ourselves. We have to prepare our soul, prepare our body, prepare everything. And basically, in the Old Testament, we will say that wash ourselves. But in this case, he is reminding us that we have to examine ourselves and not to just say that we are partaking of the Holy Communion without first taking stock of whether or not we are worthy of it. The Holy Communion is supposed to be partaken by believers who have been baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and in the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And also, it allows members to be one in Christ because he shed his blood. He did that so that we would remember. He said we should do this in remembrance of him. So if we want to show our fellowship, association, obedience to God, to Christ, then we must prepare ourselves, and it is only given to those who have been baptized, not to unbaptized members. And it is a serious thing also because we may think, oh, it's nothing, but it's really, really serious to come unprepared. Whether or not you are baptized, you have to be prepared and you have to be consecrated in every part of you so that when you partake of it, you are showing the Lord Jesus Christ that you understand the sufferings he went through, you understand what he has done for you, and you are grateful and you thank him and you praise him for what he has done for you. And so that is the reason for reading this passage, and we pray that we, as we gather to partake of it, we will do so humbly and ask the Lord to give us the entry or acceptance into his presence as we partake of it. We will now kneel down and pray.